I had a retarded daughter, and I always wanted to know why. And well, then, so we were, at that time, we were using 2,4-D and all the insecticides, and I was had a sprayer, and I was going out spraying for other people, and I had to step on my hands all the time. You know, the sprayer would plug up, and we'd, you know, oh boy, not knowing what was doing. But anyhow, got through that anyhow while the cows weren't doing so good, and kept getting worse and worse, and you could just tell. But nobody, the county agent, well, I can get you somebody to help or whatever, you know. But no, they never had an answer.
Yeah. I'd have been out there handling the chemicals like Randy says. You have to dress up and wear a mask. And when they first started using them, they didn't do that. They just used them barehanded. And
breathe all the stuff.
Breathe the dust and everything. Well, I wouldn't be here.
My dad, when I was growing up, well, he followed all the recommendations from the extension people and the feed store people and that kind of stuff, you know, and that's what got us into trouble, really. We didn't realize it, had no idea. And yeah, well, that's how I see it now, that it was our mistake, so we had to fix it.
I think people have the mindset that if it was harmful, the government would stop it. We've seen too many instances when the government doesn't stop harmful things.
Yeah, I wish I'd have known then what I know now. I would have had a better herd, but that's how you go through these things. I wouldn't have been giving them all that poison feed there at first, see. That's hard to get across to people, so, you know. People just can't believe that corn and beans is toxic waste. There's no other word for it. So the milk, all the milk that's coming from those herds is considered as toxic waste. I mean, that's not nice. I mean, you don't like to tell that on some friends off dairies or whatever. You don't like to do that. So you don't. You just let them figure it out.
Well, it's the no-till capital of the world, you know, Knox County. Most people connect that with not using chemicals, and I says, oh, it's entirely wrong. They use chemicals, that's why it's no-till. And I can't help but think eventually this is going to be a disaster with all the chemicals they use and everything. I don't see how it could not affect our water supply, because there's so much of it in Knox County. But I don't know. I've been living in my little corner of the world here, not getting out much anymore, but I worry about the future. Seems like our government is not protecting us against these things because the chemical companies have gotten so powerful. They lobby in Congress to get everything they want and so on. And people just accept it. And I don't know. I think it's going to take a big jolt somewhere or other to make them change. But I just don't see how it cannot affect things.